To experience exactly what a Headwater self-guided activity holiday is like, I flew to Turin with my husband Peter to enjoy the stunning scenery and gastronomic delights of Piedmont.
The view behind me kind of sums up why Piedmont is such a great place for an activity holiday, walking or cycling. You essentially are going from one hilltop village to the next, up and down the hills, exploring the vineyards, discovering amazing restaurants. No wonder this is a gastronomic themed tour.
Having enjoyed some time at our first hotel, we couldn't wait to get out on the road. But first, we needed to get kitted out. Not being regular cyclists, we opted to try out e-bikes. Headwater rep Luke gave me the rundown.
What I'm going to do is just chat you through how to get it started for your ride. So the battery goes underneath or in the pannier rack just here. You've got obviously the connection point here and there, so you need to line that up. And you have to force it in a little bit, but don't be shy. In it goes. You can see the weight has
back.
Just shifted
right.
Back onto itself.
Okay.
So, what we need to just do here is to push the button here to check the battery has charge.
Yeah.
We're good to go and press on now.
Right.
So when we press the on button, there we go, and it's going to scroll up to medium and then full.
So how long should the battery last?
The battery will last all day if you've charged it up.
Okay.
Because your distances are only around 40 kilometres maximum, and the battery should last about 70 kilometres on low. It's not a motor, you're not sort of speeding off, but you're going up a hill and it almost feels like someone's just giving you a nice little push
yes.
up
that
hill.
That sounds really good to me.
Yeah, which is great.
That sounds perfect.
And if you want a harder push, you obviously go higher in the
higher.
Modes.
Right, okay.
But for now, use with low and you'll be pleasantly surprised.
Out on the road, we were cycling mostly on quiet country roads or tracks. Some stretches on the flat, but also a fair number of climbs up to the hilltop villages that characterise the Lange Valley.
Well, this is where the e-bikes really come into their own. There's no way I'd get up some of these hills on an ordinary bike without stopping. You are still pedalling, of course, and you are putting in a little bit of effort, but when your legs are tired or you need that extra boost, you just push the button. It's fantastic.
I found the e-bike really easy to use. They're actually very intuitive and you get used to them really quickly. I know for a lot of people the joy of cycling is the physical challenge, powering up hills. But if you're only interested in cycling for pleasure, this really is the way forward.
And in Piedmont, aside from the beautiful scenery, there's a great deal of pleasure in visiting the wineries and exploring the quiet villages. Finding our way was also easy using the Ride with GPS app. You download the Headwater route to your phone before you set off, and even offline, it will track you and give audible directions.
In 1 kilometre, turn right.
And if you go wrong at any point, you'll hear an alert and you can quickly get back on track. These are point-to-point touring holidays, so usually every 2 nights you'll move on.
In a 0.5 kilometre, turn right.
It's the best incentive to keep pedalling when you know there's a gorgeous hotel to relax in at the end of your ride. And aside from the lovely hotels, indulging in the food and wine is an equally important part of a Piedmont holiday.
In keeping with the gastronomic theme, dinner is included every night in a whole variety of different restaurants, from local osteria to very upmarket restaurants, including 2 Michelin star restaurants.
And tonight we're eating at Al Castello in Grinzane Cavour, home of Michelin star chef Mark Lanteri.
And this looks delicious.
For the second part of our trip, we were walking. Normally, on a Headwater holiday, you'd choose either a walking or cycling itinerary, but there's always flexibility to adapt itineraries to suit you. Perhaps add extra rest days, or mix and match itineraries according to your interests.
Well, obviously, when you're cycling, you can cover a lot more ground, but I really love the slow pace of the walking. Being able to stop whenever you come across
stunning views like this, and on a clear day like today, it doesn't get any better really.
We were following the Headwater written directions for the walking, and they were really very detailed and clear.
Turn right along the road. Very soon you pass a small chapel on the right, and then after passing a house on the left, turn left into a wide turning area.
And on top of the notes, there's also lots of local painted markers and signs. It really would be quite difficult to get lost. Although this is a self-guided holiday, you have the support of the local Headwater reps. Luke and Eleanor told me about their role.
Well, the main things is we meet people at the airport or train station and we transfer them to their first hotel in region. And that evening or the next morning, we sit down and we run through the itinerary, whether it's a walking or cycling holiday.
We move their luggage while they walk or they cycle. We also book them into restaurants in the evening. We also book any taxis and transfers to and from the airport as well. So we really are behind the scenes a lot of the time doing the logistics of the holiday.
So it's a really sort of personal service, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really tailored to individual customers' needs.
Yeah.
It's self-guided, so it really is on your terms.
We thoroughly enjoyed our time in Piedmont. It really is a lovely region for an activity holiday and feels all the more special as it's definitely less touristy than some other regions.
But the overriding positive for me is the balance between activity and enjoying the food and wine. I'm not expecting to have lost any weight, but I'm certainly going home feeling a bit fitter. And indulgence without the guilt has to be a good thing.